Let us guide you through the protocol for analyzing genomic DNA samples using the hPSC Genetic Analysis Kit. This video will provide step-by-step instructions for preparing the hPSC Genetic Analysis Reagents, setting up the qPCR reaction and preparing DNA master mixes, and pipetting mixtures into a qPCR plate. Thaw all hPSC genetic analysis components on ice and protect from light. Before starting, genomic DNA samples to be analyzed should be placed on ice and concentration determined using a nanodrop spectrophotometer or other method. First, prepare the qPCR master mix by adding the appropriate volume of ROX reference dye. The volume will vary depending on the qPCR machine being used. Mix the solution thoroughly before use. Next, prepare the genetic assays. Centrifuge the tubes at 750 times G for 10 seconds. Then, add 33 microliters of TE buffer to each tube. Pipette the solution up and down the sides of the tube to ensure complete resuspension. Return the tubes to the icebox and protect from light. The hPSC Genetic Analysis Kit reagents are now ready for use. First, add 1.5 microliters of genomic DNA control to 56.5 microliters of nuclease-free water into a 0.65 mL tube. Then, add 290 nanograms of each genomic DNA sample to separate 0.65 mL tubes. Add water to a total volume of 58 microliters. Once all samples have been prepared, vortex the 2x qPCR master mix. Then add 145 microliters to the genomic DNA control and each genomic DNA sample. The qPCR master mix is viscous, so once added, pipette up and down carefully 2 to 3 times to mix. Then place the tube back on ice and protect from light. Next, calculate the required number of reactions for each of the 9 genetic assays. It is recommended to run the assay using 3 technical replicates. The number of reactions required is calculated by multiplying the number of samples to be analyzed by 3. To allow for sufficient excess of material, add additional reactions based on the number of samples to be analyzed. For example, if 4 samples are being analyzed, 14 reactions per genetic assay are required. Now, prepare each genetic assay in a separate tube. Add an appropriate volume of nuclease-free water, followed by an appropriate volume of genetic assay stock solution for each reaction based on your previous calculations. Vortex each genetic assay before addition. Be sure to change pipette tips between respective genetic assays to avoid cross-contamination of oligonucleotides. Once each genetic assay has been prepared, it should be placed on ice and protected from light. Next, add the prepared mixtures into a qPCR plate. Using a felt pen, mark a 3x9 well boundary for each sample on a 384 well PCR plate. Angle the plate at approximately 30 degrees by taping the top edge to a microcentrifuge tube rack or something of similar nature. Take each genomic DNA sample combined with master mix prepared previously. Vortex thoroughly and spin briefly. Then, using a manual or multi-dispense pipette, add 7 microliters of the sample to the bottom edge of each well, keeping within the marked 3x9 well boundary. Repeat with each genomic DNA sample until all samples have been loaded onto the plate. Next, take each genetic assay in turn, vortex thoroughly and spin the contents briefly. Using a manual or multi-dispense pipette, add 3 microliters of the genetic assay to the top edge of each well in the respective plate rows. Repeat with each genetic assay until all 9 have been loaded onto the plate. Once both components have been added, cover the plate using optical adhesive film. Make sure all edges and wells are sealed properly using a scraper or roller. Then, centrifuge for 1 to 2 minutes at 1,000 times G to collect each reaction at the bottom of the wells. The plate can now be placed in a quantitative PCR system and run using the following cycling conditions. The CT values obtained should be reorganized into the format shown. They can then be pasted directly into the online application found at stemcell.com. The online genomic analysis app can be used to easily interpret data. The app produces graphs as well as statistical analysis of each sample analyzed. If an abnormality is observed in the sample, the assay can be repeated to confirm or sent for further analysis using G-banding or other methods. For more information about this kit, please visit stemcell.com.